Hey everyone, welcome back to another Stryd workout of the week. As always, my name is Evan. Today we're going to be recapping last week's winners and then talking about this week's workout of the week. Thanks to everybody for running last week's 1-5-1 fartlek. You can always enter to win a free month of Stryd membership by tagging your workout of the week on social media with hashtag Stryd. Wow, that's hashtag Strydwow. You can see last week's winners here on the screen. Thanks everybody so much for entering to win. Now let's talk about this week's workout of the week. The workout of the week is a rotating collection that we update every single Wednesday and we build for you here on the Stryd YouTube channel. You can always tune in to see the most recent workout of the week and see how we use the workout builder to build each workout. Today we're going to be talking about Lindsay's half marathon prep. We'll go to the Stryd workout builder and build the workout for you. This workout comes from US elite marathoner Lindsay Flanagan, who has placed top 10 at both the Chicago and Boston Marathon. This workout is focused on making sure you feel pretty confident to switch gears between about 10K effort and half marathon effort and be able to run your best possible effort at half marathon. We'll start with a warm-up of 10 minutes at 70 to 80% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. Then we'll do a 3-minute section at 96 to 100% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power, just to get your legs moving a little bit quicker underneath you. We'll do a 2-minute recovery at 70 to 80% to make sure that you feel good and recovered before we tack on some Stryds. These Stryds are going to be a 2-step repeat with a 20-second on portion at 100 to 110% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power, with a 40-second recovery at 70 to 80% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. After that, we'll do another short block of recovery at 70 to 80% before diving into the bulk of the workout. The format of this workout is going to be 4 times 400, 4 times 1 kilometer, and then 4 times 400. You can do this on a track, you could do this out on the road, you could do this even on a trail, but it is going to be inherently a distance-based workout. We're going to use timed recoveries in between, but the on portions are going to be distance-based. Let's start by building the first set, and that will be 4 times 400. And we're going to run right around your critical power, starting a little bit below and finishing a little bit above. So the range here we're going to give you is 400 meters at 99 to 103% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. The rest in between these 400s is going to be a little bit shorter. It's going to be about a minute, and we'll do 70 to 80% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. You can start a little bit easier towards that 99% and build up throughout the course of each repeat, or you can do, you know, 99%, 100%, 101%, 102% as the workout goes on. But the first set of this 4 times 400 is going to be 99 to 103% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. We're going to jump immediately into the block of 4 times 1 kilometer, and these are going to be between 94 and 98% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. These are supposed to be a little bit more in line with that half marathon intensity, and you can always go to the Stryd race power calculator and event planner to find out your specific half marathon power and adjust things a little bit if you want to nail in that target a little bit better. We're going to do a 2-minute jog between 70 to 80% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power in between each of these kilometer repeats. We're going to do 4 of them. After we finish the fourth one, we're going to jump right back into another set of those 4 times 400 with a minute jog recovery. The intensity here is going to be the exact same thing. It's going to be 99 to 103% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. We're going to do a minute jog in between at 70 to 80% of your Stryd auto-calculated critical power. After that, we'll hop into a short cool down to wrap up the workout. Some words of advice for this workout. If you feel like the intensity is a little bit too much, you can reduce the overall volume by subtracting one repeat from each set. So you can change it to 3 times 400, 3 times a K, 3 times 400. You could also increase things a little bit if you want to increase it to 5 to 6 times 400, keep it around 4 to 5 times 1K, and then do 4 to 6 times 400 as well if you want to bump things up a little bit. And again, that top tip of being able to use the Stryd race power calculator and event planner to nail things in just a little bit more, that would be our top tip for this workout. We hope you enjoyed this workout explaining Lindsay's half marathon prep. Again, this is an interval workout you could do on the track, on the roads, you could take it to any surface, but this distance-based workout is gonna be great to get you prepared for that half marathon race. We'll see you again next week for another Stryd workout of the week. Bye-bye.